So you're probably wondering,
where have I been? The best game show on American television. I'm your host, Sean Hibbs, and for our first contestant, we have the big money question. Where have I been? Well, it's an honor to be here, sir. Well, I'm glad you feel that way. Anyway, now it's time for you to answer the big money winning question. All right, there's gonna be four different answers you can choose from. Is it A, I've been diagnosed with a terminal illness? Is it B, I accidentally procrastinated for 3 months? Is it C, Terry, please put answer C here, I'm on lunch break in 2 minutes? Or is it D, I decided to work on two of the biggest projects of my life so far and regretted it almost immediately? Well, out of those four, probably D. Well, congratulations, because you are now a millionaire. Oh my gosh, I won! I can't believe. So in my last video, I said I wouldn't be uploading for a while, but I not mean 4 months. So if you've been keeping up with my community posts, you would know that I've been working on two of the biggest projects of my life, and they're taking a ton of time and effort. But I also have an audition to catch. Let me explain. So I'm in 8th grade, which means I'm going to high school next year, and that is absolutely ridiculous to think about, but let's not get ahead of ourselves. So in my theater class, yeah, that one, has a separate class that you can take in high school called theater production, which is professional theater. Now, this is a highly sophisticated class, and they only want the best of the best, but there are only 20 spots open. Ever since I first heard about this class, I couldn't stop thinking about it. I mean, if you told me about this class, my mind would be blown. I mean, this class is like my dream. This isn't just about having a lot of fun doing acting. This could help me a ton in my future filmmaking career. So, how do I get in?
Well, the good news is that they made me a list of all the things that I have to do, but
this is gonna be a lot harder than I thought. All right, let me just run down the details of the audition here. Oh, and sorry in advance if this whole part sounds weird. I'm sick right now, so there's like mucus in the back of my throat and it's all nasty and stuff, so I can't really talk right. Also, I'm reading off my laptop, and when I'm reading straight from a script, my brain don't work, all right? Alright, so back to the video. First thing I need to do is write a 1-page essay. The essay is worth 40% of the grade and is very important. Next, I'll have to perform 2 monologues, 1 comedic and 1 dramatic, about 2 minutes long. The monologues are also worth 40% of the grade. Now, those are the two main things, but I also need a couple of other things too. Like, I need signed recommendations from all 8 of my teachers, which is worth 5% of the grade. Then, I need to get some nice clothes, which that's also 5%. But you're probably thinking, well, what about the extra 10%? Well, 5% goes to what my current theater grades are, and the other 5% is my tardiness for the school so far. Now, I will admit, I am a little guilty of not being able to show up to rehearsals and practices on time. That's because I've had the worst luck when it comes to being sick or having to do something important that day. It's just been a whole mess. It's actually what got me kicked off of a play one time, or I got put into an understudy. It wasn't like I got completely kicked off, but I still really regret that because I feel like I really missed my opportunity to prove myself on that play. But back to the audition. I need to plan this out to make sure I get everything perfect. So here's what I'm gonna do.
First, I'm going to write the essay. I'll probably have to make revisions throughout the entire thing, but that's why I'm doing it first.
Second, I need to get my teacher evaluations. I probably won't record a lot of that though, because a lot of my teachers don't like being recorded.
Now third, I'm going to be doing my monologues. This is by far the hardest part and a challenge on my acting capabilities as a whole.
And after all of that, I'm gonna get some nice clothes because they were very clear about that on the paper. Oh, and all of this needs to be done by April 24th, which is like 2 weeks from now.
Woo, that's a brilliant plan, is it?
Brilliant.
This essay has to really grab their attention and really make them think that I should be in this class. So let's start writing. Okay, so I've been stressing over this essay for days, and I finally have it done, but there's just one teensy tiny little problem. So it turns out I had completely misread what was on the paper. The audition is on April 24th, but I need to have the essay done and my two monologues selected and printed to be put in a packet that is due April 17th,
which is in like 3 days.
So, it was the next day, and I needed to get my teacher evaluations, but here's the thing. I knew I was already getting an early dismissal that day because I was getting pretty sick, which means I wouldn't be able to see all my teachers that day, even though I needed their evaluations as soon as possible. Luckily for me, my BCTV teacher is chill and let me get out of first period to go to all my other classes and get their evaluations.
So it's the next day and I decided to stay after school to get some help from my theater friends to pick out my monologues and get them printed, which are right here, and I have everything ready by tomorrow to be given to my theater teacher, so everything should be fine. So yeah, let's wait till tomorrow. Whew, that was way too close. Hopefully there wasn't like a paper missing from the packet that I turned in. That would be terrible. Oh my gosh, I forgot to put the report card in the packet. Oh my gosh. Just kidding, my mom brought it to the school the next day. Thank you, Mom.
But now, it's time to learn these monologues.
Your eyes staring into my eyes. Who am I, the guy with two eyes on the prize? And the prize in my eyes is 10 times the surprise in your eyes as I kiss you goodnight. Your smile is the fire that rocks my soul. Gonna remember it until I grow old. Cause life is too short, we gotta do things right. So baby, let's just party tonight. Baby, let's just party tonight.
Okay, now that we're all done with that, it's time to get some nice clothes. So me and my mom went to the mall to go and get some nice clothes. All I really need is a dress shirt, some slacks, and some dress shoes. We looked around the mall for a while and couldn't really find anything, so we just decided to order everything. Now, it says here that the clothes should be arriving the day before the audition, on April 23rd. Alright guys, I have some bad news. Alright, so it's April 23rd, the day before the audition, and I just got a notification that the order has been delayed to tomorrow. So, new game plan. After school, if the packages get here, I'm gonna have to run all the way here and change into that. I have a backup pair of clothes, but they're not really what I wanna wear to an audition, but they're better than what I'm wearing right now. So, I've changed into clothes, I have to run all the way back to the high school just in time for my audition, and hopefully I make it in time, I rush in there, and everybody's cheering me on, and I blow the judges away, and they're like, you need to be the new president of the production company, and I'm like, heck yeah, I will, because I'm the coolest kid here. Maybe not the whole last part, but you get the point.
Why did you cancel the show? We can still do this.
There's not enough time. Listen, we need a lot of actors for the show, and with who we've even got now, we'd still need at least 50 more people. And there's only 2 months left of school.
So we can find more people, or double cast?
No, you're not listening, alright? We only have Tuesdays and Thursdays to film, and that would only leave us with 20 days left, and that would be to film and find more actors.
So what? Gonna give up? But this is your biggest project ever. Sean, you've worked toward this for over a year.
No, do not even say that, okay? I never give up. You know that. There's always a way. I just have to figure this out. How about high school, okay? We can rewrite the scripts, do this in high school.
what?
I'm trying out for theater production next year. That class is huge, and it takes up a lot of time. I would have no way of doing the show if I'm in that class.
Alright, how about this? If they don't accept me, then I'll just do the show next year.
But what if they do accept you?
I first fell in love with theater when I was 9 years old. Me and my mom would go do plays for a local nonprofit theater organization called Impromptu Players, where I got my first look at production work. We did about 3 different plays before I went to a summer camp that they had, which is where I really started getting into acting. Soon afterward, I moved to Bridge City, and I took both Theater 1 and Theater 2. And I've definitely learned a lot more about what being a great actor is. And while I have had my faults this year, that being an attendance or broad partner experience, I do think that I can be quick to grow past these faults in theater production. This school year, I've learned to not be afraid of taking risks, and I feel that this is a key component of becoming the best actor you can be, and I hope I can learn even more from theater production. I believe that the theater production class will help me immensely in a directing field of work, and it would be best if I took acting in a more advanced and professional way. And with some help from my teachers, classmates, and the intermission popcorn, I can definitely bring any script in this class to life. That was the essay that I wrote for theater production, and to be honest with you, I'm not sure if I'm gonna make it or not. And to be even more honest with you, I'd be happy either way. At this point, I just have to see where the universe takes me. And even though this class may put a halt on some of the filmmaking stuff that I want to do, I'll still find ways to do filmmaking no matter what. And I am doing a BCTV class next year, and that will help a ton. And that is, of course, if I even get in the class. So, I'll see you guys tomorrow.